Washington CDL tanker vehicles test.
Question 1. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you can see ahead, the length of your vehicle, the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds.
Answer:
the distance you can see ahead.
Question 2. How would you expect the truck with the cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will seem heavier than it really is. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Answer:
there will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 3. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled door stab braking.
Answer:
use controlled door stab braking.
Question 4. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Always. Never.
Answer:
always.
Question 5. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight, water content.
Answer:
distribution of weight.
Question 6. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons:
uneven expansion, extreme weight, liquid movement.
Answer:
liquid movement.
Question 7. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called
baffles, barriers, bulkheads.
Answer:
baffles.
Question 8. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly, downshift twice, speed up slightly.
Answer:
speed up slightly.
Question 9. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer:
there will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 10. Side-to-side surge can cause
suspension system failure, a rollover, overspeeding.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 11. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping, driving against the wind.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 12. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
water content, distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 13. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 14. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will seem heavier than it really is. The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 15. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
High center of gravity. Both of these answers are correct. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 16. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 17. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
water content, distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 18. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
barriers, baffles, bulkheads.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 19. Outage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain. Allowance for expansion of liquid. Liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 20. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be a slower surge than quick surge.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 21. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
starting or stopping, going uphill or downhill, driving against the wind.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 22. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Top to bottom. Side to side. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 23. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 24. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
driving against the wind, starting or stopping, going uphill or downhill.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 25. Outage means
allowance for expansion of liquid. Liquid weight. How fast the liquid tanks drain.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 26. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
The truck will roll over. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck. You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 27. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 28. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge lets you turn corners tighter. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 29. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Always. Never. Only if the tank has baffles.
Answer.
Always.
Question 30. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm.
Question 31. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 32. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
use only the emergency brakes. Lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use controlled door stab braking.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 33. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping, driving against the wind.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 34. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Always. Never.
Answer.
Always.
Question 35. Empty trucks
may require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 36. Outage means
liquid weight. How fast the liquid tanks drain. Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 37. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. The truck will roll over. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 38. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds. The length of your vehicle. The distance you can see ahead.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 39. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
loading and unloading, hauling milk or other food products, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 40. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 41. Which of these statements about emergency steering and tankers is true?
A tanker is easier to countersteer than most vehicles. Use only the emergency brakes. You should wrap your thumbs around the steering wheel before starting a quick steering movement.
Answer.
Use only the emergency brakes.
Question 42. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Liquid movement. High center of gravity. Both of these answers are correct.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 43. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
barriers, bulkheads, baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 44. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. The truck will seem heavier than it really is. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 45. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
distribution of weight, water content, air-to-fuel ratio.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 46. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Always. Only if the tank has baffles. Never.
Answer.
Always.
Question 47. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
speed up slightly. Brake lightly. Downshift twice.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 48. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 49. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called
bulkheads, barriers, baffles.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 50. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Always. Only if the tank has baffles. Never.
Answer.
Always.
Question 51. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled doorstep braking.
Answer.
Use controlled doorstep braking.
Question 52. Altage means
allowance for expansion of liquid. How fast the liquid tanks drain. Liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 53. Liquid tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
bulkheads, barriers, baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 54. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 55. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 56. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called
barriers, baffles, bulkheads.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 57. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. The truck will roll over. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 58. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Side to side. Top to bottom. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 59. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping, driving against the wind.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 60. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you can see ahead. The distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds. The length of your vehicle.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 61. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Extreme weight. Liquid movement. Uneven expansion.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 62. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
driving against the wind, going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 63. The liquid in a tank with baffles can still have what kind of surge?
Front to back. Side to side. Top to bottom.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 64. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Liquid movement. Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 65. Empty trucks
have better traction when stopping than full trucks. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks. Stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 66. Side-to-side surge can cause
a rollover, overspeeding, suspension system failure.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 67. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expand more than others when they get warm.
Question 68. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Only if the tank has baffles. Never. Always.
Answer.
Always.
Question 69. When should the driver of a tanker that has lost its brakes use a truck escape ramp?
Always. Only if the tank has baffles. Never.
Answer.
Always.
Question 70. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles. The truck will seem heavier than it really is.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 71. Liquid-tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called?
Barriers. Bulkheads. Baffles.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 72. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 73. Side-to-side surge can cause
a rollover, overspeeding, suspension system failure.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 74. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
going uphill or downhill, driving against the wind, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 75. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 76. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be a slower surge than quick surge.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 77. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called?
Barriers. Baffles. Bulkheads.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 78. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
water content, air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 79. Outage means
allowance for expansion of liquid, how fast the liquid tanks drain, liquid weight.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 80. Liquid-tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called
baffles, Barriers. Bulkheads.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 81. Side-to-side surge can cause.
Overspeeding. Suspension system failure. A rollover.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 82. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you can see ahead. The length of your vehicle. The distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 83. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 84. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge lets you turn corners tighter. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 85. Empty trucks
stop quicker when you use only the emergency or parking brake. Have better traction when stopping than full trucks. May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Answer.
May require a longer stopping distance than full trucks.
Question 86. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
High center of gravity. Both of these answers are correct. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 87. Outage means
allowance for expansion of liquid. Liquid weight. How fast the liquid tanks drain.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 88. You are driving a tanker truck. The front wheels begin to skid. Which of these is most likely to occur?
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer. The truck will roll over. Liquid surge will pull the tank from the truck.
Answer.
You will continue in a straight line and keep moving forward no matter how you steer.
Question 89. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits. The amount the liquid will expand in transit. Both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 90. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called?
Barriers. Baffles. Bulkheads.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 91. Liquid-tight separators between compartments inside tanks are called?
Baffles. Bulkheads. Barriers.
Answer.
Bulkheads.
Question 92. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly. Downshift twice. Speed up slightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 93. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds. The length of your vehicle. The distance you can see ahead.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 94. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled doorstep braking.
Answer.
Use controlled doorstep braking.
Question 95. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
loading and unloading, starting or stopping, hauling milk or other food products.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 96. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the amount the liquid will expend in transit, the legal weight limits, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 97. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge lets you turn corners tighter. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 98. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
air to fuel ratio, water content, distribution of weight.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 99. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
High center of gravity. Both of these answers are correct. Liquid movement.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 100. The amount of liquid to load into a tank depends on
the legal weight limits, the amount the liquid will expend in transit, both of the above factors.
Answer.
Both of the above factors.
Question 101. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
brake lightly. Speed up slightly. Downshift twice.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 102. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Side to side. Top to bottom. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 103. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Liquid movement. Both of these answers are correct. High center of gravity.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 104. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge lets you turn corners tighter. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 105. Which of these statements about stopping distance and speed is true?
You need about 2 times as much stopping distance at 40 miles per hour as at 20 miles per hour. Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed. Both of the above are true.
Answer.
Wet roads can double stopping distance at any speed.
Question 106. Outage means
how fast the liquid tanks drain. Liquid weight. Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Answer.
Allowance for expansion of liquid.
Question 107. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 108. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage. Some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 109. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 110. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 111. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
starting or stopping, driving against the wind, going uphill or downhill.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 112. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled door stab braking.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 113. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
loading and unloading, starting or stopping, hauling milk or other food products.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 114. How would you expect a truck with a cargo tank that has baffles to handle on the road?
The truck will handle the same as a tanker without baffles. The truck will seem heavier than it really is. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is in a tanker without baffles.
Question 115. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 116. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the length of your vehicle, the distance you can see ahead, the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 117. An emergency forces you to stop your tanker quickly or crash. You should
lock the brakes with the pedal and hold it there. Use only the emergency brakes. Use controlled door stab braking.
Answer.
Use controlled door stab braking.
Question 118. Side-to-side surge can cause
suspension system failure, a rollover, overspeeding.
Answer.
A rollover.
Question 119. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be a slower surge than quick surge. There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 120. The best way to take a curve with a tanker is to slow to a safe speed before entering the curve. Then, as you go through it,
downshift twice. Brake lightly. Speed up slightly.
Answer.
Speed up slightly.
Question 121. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 122. Hauling liquids in tank vehicles requires special care for two reasons.
Uneven expansion. Liquid movement. Extreme weight.
Answer.
Liquid movement.
Question 123. When you unload the smaller tanks or a tank with bulkheads, be careful to check your
water content, air to fuel ratio, distribution of weight.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 124. You should know the outage needed for the liquids you carry because
some of the heaviest liquids do not need any outage. Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm. Tank baffles are not always legal with outage.
Answer.
Some liquids expend more than others when they get warm.
Question 125. You need to be very careful when driving smoothbore tankers. This is especially true when you are
starting or stopping, loading and unloading, hauling milk or other food products.
Answer.
Starting or stopping.
Question 126. What does liquid surge do to handling of a tanker?
Surge raises the wind drag of the truck. It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move. Surge lets you turn corners tighter.
Answer.
It can move the truck in the direction the liquid waves move.
Question 127. When your cargo tank has baffles, what handling effect do you expect?
There will be less side-to-side surge than there is in a tank without baffles. There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank. There will be a slower surge than quick surge.
Answer.
There will be less front-to-back surge than there is for a tank.
Question 128. Separators, with openings or holes in them, that are between compartments in a tank are called?
Bulkheads. Barriers. Baffles.
Answer.
Baffles.
Question 129. When you load the small tanks of a cargo tank equipped with bulkheads, you should check the
distribution of weight, air to fuel ratio, water content.
Answer.
Distribution of weight.
Question 130. Hauling liquids in tankers requires special care for the following reason. S.
Liquid movement. High center of gravity. Both of these answers are correct.
Answer.
Both of these answers are correct.
Question 131. Baffles in liquid cargo tanks do not usually prevent surge.
Side to side. Top to bottom. Front to back.
Answer.
Side to side.
Question 132. You are driving on a clear night. You must dim your headlights from high to low. You should adjust your speed so that you can stop within
the length of your vehicle, the distance you can see ahead, the distance you will travel in the next 15 seconds.
Answer.
The distance you can see ahead.
Question 133. You should be very cautious when driving smoothbore tankers, especially when you are
driving against the wind, going uphill or downhill, starting or stopping.
Answer.
Starting or stopping. Thank you for watching the video and wish you will get your driver license soon.